Introduction, you write India-Afghanistan relationship, it is having a history like it is dating back to 5th century. Like that, some positive thing between India and Afghanistan, you write one line, you write. Indo-Afghanistan relation has to be traced to even 5th century. There was so much of cultural continuity because of geographical continuity. It was a gateway to come to India. The history of bilateral tie will have to be written in the introduction in one question. In another question, exactly the question, no, that thing will have to be written in a broader perspective. From a broader perspective, you have to write the introduction. Right. So after having said this, speak about India's developmental assistance to Afghanistan. Afghanistan is the only country for which India has given more than $2 billion developmental assistance. India wanted reconstruction of Afghanistan based on the wisdom of the people. And this is highlighted by India's consistent support to the democratization of Afghanistan and the developmental reconstruction of Afghanistan. India hosted the 6th Heart of Asia Conference, showing willingness to constructively contribute for the Afghan reconstruction and development. India has been investing its developmental assistance in the small and medium projects, especially in the Taliban dominated areas like Herat province. The friendship dam dedicated by India is a case in point. India has been constructing, India has successfully constructed the Zaranj Delaram highway connectivity, 200 plus kilometer highway connectivity. The reason for such assistance towards Pakistan can be discussed under the following heads. Number one, containing Pakistan. Number two, expanding the geostrategic influence. Number three, counter-religious insurgency. Number four, energy security. Explain each and every of the subtopics which I have told you. The first subtopic is containment of Pakistan. Write how Pakistan, using the concept of strategic depth, wanted to extend its tentacles all over Afghanistan through its proxy called Taliban. The rise of Islamic Republic of Afghanistan in 1996, headed by Taliban, resulted in India getting edged out of Afghanistan as Talibans were supported by Pakistan. Pakistan's support to Taliban is only to ensure that a Taliban nationalism or a Pakhtun nationalism is not coming in the way of the Pakistani intention of intensifying its strategic depth in Afghanistan. To contain Pakhtun nationalism, Pakhtuns are the largest tribe in Afghanistan and the second largest tribe in Pakistan, So the possibility of a Pagato nationalism may be detrimental to the territorial sovereignty of Pakistan society. Using Islamic, using religious unity, using religious nationalism, they are trying to contain the sub-nationalism based on Pakhtun identity. That is the game plan of Pakistan in Afghanistan. Secondly, Raja Mohan, see Raja Mohan writes about how India's foreign policy is dividing the world into three concentric circles. One is immediate neighborhood. Number two is the circle of extended neighborhood. Number three is the rest of the world. These are the three concentric circles which was made out of the world by India's foreign policy makers, according to the strategist called, foreign policy commentator called Raja Mohan. Immediate neighborhood. India wanted to have a veto power in the affairs of the immediate neighborhood. In the extended neighborhood, India wanted to balance the designs of the other players. We wanted to balance the power of the other players in the extended neighborhood. And thirdly, in the rest of the world, India wanted to position itself as one of the great power which can contribute for the international peace and security. So, to influence the regional politics as well as economics and geostrategics, India is wanting to give assistance to Afghanistan. Thirdly, rise of religious insurgency. Taliban is spearheading religious nationalism using violence. India never accepted the classification of the US or China as they try to classify Talibans as good Talibans and bad Talibans. For India, there is only one Taliban. There is no such good Taliban or bad Taliban. In 1996, from 1996 to 2001, Indian embassy was shut down because of the Taliban rule. Pakistan started using Afghanistan to harbor state-sponsored terrorism against India. So, rise of religious nationalism in the immediate neighborhood of India does not augur well with the peace and security in the Indian subcontinent. Through developmental assistance, India wanted to ensure employment to be generated in Afghanistan, because it is the unemployed youths who become rented Talibans. There is so much of agricultural growth possibilities in Afghanistan. Infrastructural bottlenecks are barriers to realizing the transformation of Afghanistan. And that is why India wanted to invest in the small infrastructural projects, hydro dam projects, which will give employment opportunity for the local people of Afghanistan, unlike the Chinese who used to bring laborer from their own country, resulting in unemployment problem for the Afghanistani people. This speaks about why India's developmental assistance is celebrated, whereas the Chinese investment in Afghanistan is resented. Fourthly, energy. India to grow at 8.6% consistently will have to do only with the help of energy security, because energy security is an inevitable component of India's modernity, economic modernity. There are so much of energy reserves present in Afghanistan, which is now tapped by the Chinese petroleum companies in the Amu Darya Basin, especially in Sargi Pool. And Afghanistan becomes a gateway to the Asian, Central Asian hydrocarbon reserves. With the help of Afghanistan as a gateway, we can access the hydrocarbon, especially present in the Caspian Sea. Thereby, we can fuel our growth, because growth is imperative for the stabilization of Indian economy. Energy security is imperative for the stabilization of Indian economy. India should not be influenced by the fact that Afghanistan is more under the influence of China today. More and more investments, economic commercial investments, are made by Chinese in Afghanistan today. China wanted the economic opportunities in Afghanistan to be seized. India should conduct bilateral relationship with Afghanistan not based on its foreign policy using a prism of China. On the individual merits of both countries, India will have to harmonize the strategic, political, economic, and the cultural arms of both the countries. Rise of India as a soft power in Afghanistan is what is lauded by the international community today. India wisely chose not to play any combat role in Afghanistan's reconstruction. Rather, it was positioning itself as a soft power in Afghanistan's reconstruction, politically and economically.